this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. Today I'm in Paris. Well, no, I'm not in Paris, France, actually. I'm in Paris, Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm here at the Paris Hotel and the Convention Center, Le Centre des Conventions. I don't speak French, although my nephew does. And what I'm here today for is a special show that's only open to dealers with basically garden exhibits that are now available or should be available soon at your local garden center. So if you see any of the products in this episode, make sure you go to your local garden center and ask them, hey, can you guys get this product? And they probably can. And then you could get them near you at a local garden center, right? And so I value local garden centers. You know, they're the best place to get support, the best place to get plants. So I want you guys to support them instead of supporting, you know, like big box stores, for example. Support your local garden centers, your local hardware stores. The small guys work hard to earn a living and to continue their business to provide, you know, communities around the country, you know, some of the best products. And in this episode, I'm going to show you guys some of the best gardening products that allow you to basically up your game in organics. It allows you to basically take organics to the next level and use some of the high-end organic products that might only usually be used in growing medicinal herbs that sell for, you know, I don't know, lots of money. But you guys could use these same very products in your home garden to grow high quality food, because that's what I'm about. I'm about growing high quality food and basically using nature's methods and using nature to my advantage to grow food. So let's head in the convention center. I want to show you guys actually the first booth here in the garden show, and it's actually right here. It's actually a novelty manufacturing. And they make a whole bunch of different containers. Actually, I have some of these in my own garden that I'm growing my tea plants in. But also, they make, these guys are now, they're making the Earthbox. So you know, the whole topic of this episode today is I really want to get you guys into not just, you know, standard gardening, right? Standard gardening may use chemical fertilizers, right? Conventional methods of growing, which is basically man-derived chemicals. Right? Hey, that's good. If you're going to grow your food with chemicals, that's better than buying food from the store. But even after that, right, even Earthbox has an organic kit, right? So this is their standard kit with a special plant food. And hey, I love the Earthboxes, right? These are the best designed self-watering containers. They're really durable. They're well designed, so they're not going to break on you like some of the cheap imitation versions. But even Earthbox, they have smaller ones and they have ones for roots, but they have a replant kit. And actually, this is the organic version. So they have an organic replant kit. So instead of using the chemicals, now you're working more with nature and using organic improved ingredients. And hey, that's great. And this is where most gardeners stop. They, as long as they have organic ingredients they could use to grow food, they're totally happy. But I want you guys to take it up to the next level, right? The next level, even beyond growing organic, is growing what I call organic biologic gardening, and that's actually what I teach on my channel. Besides just doing organic, which is de facto standard now, not conventional growing, I'm also taking into consideration other creatures on the planet, the microbes, the fungi, the birds and the bees, the insects, right? And we want to work nature in the best way possible so that we can have the best production, the highest productivity, but also have a lighter footprint on the planet. And actually, I'm glad that Earthbox has taken a leadership position, and they're now going to have this kit, this Earthbox, which is the one I would recommend you guys get. And actually, it's the Earthbox Probiotic Wellness Garden. I mean, it's summed up right there. Probiotic Wellness Garden, right? If you work with nature, you're going to have the highest quality food. And there's going to be probiotics that live within us that are going to live on your plants and also in the soil that are going to help break down the organic matter to give you a more productive organic garden. And that's what they're doing here. They basically got the Malibu compost with the soil. You're going to fill this in here. They got the Grokashi or Bokashi. They also got the natural fertilizer. But now what you have in this kit is you have the fertilizer activator. The EM1, these are basically beneficial microbes and fungi that are basically gonna break down the different nutrients in the potting soil and the compost and basically feed your plants. In addition, this may provide resiliency to your plants, right? Bacteria, there's all kinds of bacteria. People know about bad bacteria. Those are the things that could cause you to have a cold, get the flu, right? And there's good bacteria, and there's bacteria somewhere in the middle that are neither good nor bad, but they could go bad or they could go good depending on who they hang out with, right? If you have a kid and the kid hangs out with the bad kids at school that are into drugs and stealing stuff, right? That's how your kid's gonna end up, right? If your kid's hanging out with the you know, the nerdy kids, the good kids at study, right? That's how your kid's more likely to end up. And same thing with the bacteria, right? So you wanna basically put the good guys in there so that all the other bacteria kind of just step in line and then they're gonna be good too. And so that's actually what the EM1 product does. So this, I like that this is an all-in-one kit, so now people can grow organic biologic. This would be perfect kit if you guys have like a little patio or live in an apartment or a condo. So yeah, Earthbox Probiotic Wellness Garden. Actually, yeah, let's go ahead and continue to walk around the show and show you guys actually another product I like a lot. All right, so the next booth I want to show with you guys is actually called the Blacksmith Bioscience. And I'll tell you guys, actually one night, you know, many nights, actually I'm researching online different products that could help me in my garden when I have a specific situation. And one of the products I found was from Blacksmith Bioscience. And I'm like, man, I hope one day I run into them. And sure enough, they're here. So I'm super glad that they are here. I will say that normally their products are definitely usually thought of as higher end products and used in medicinal herb cultivation, so like cannabis, right? But I believe their products should be out to people that even grow vegetables and fruits, right? Because they are so beneficial, and basically they're biologic ways to control a pest, increase plant health, and get more nutrients to your plants without actually even investing in fertilizer. So let's learn about them here. Now this is not the most exciting display here, but basically what we have is a couple of different packages, right? And in these packages is like pixie dust. No, just kidding. So in these packages are beneficial microbes that have certain roles and do certain tasks. And these have been well researched and documented. So for example, this one is called nitrix. And this is basically, this contains nitrogen fixing bacteria. So you guys know that if you guys plant peas or bean crops, right? Those crops have nitrogen fixing bacteria that can basically take nitrogen out of the air and put that in your soil. And that's why cover cropping with a bean plant is so beneficial, right? Because there's this bacteria that lives on the pea plants that do this, right? But what you could do is if you got this bacteria, right, this bacteria will basically just work in your soil and pull nitrogen out of the air and put it into the soil. So literally, you are literally creating free fertilizer for your plants with this product, right? In addition, they got this stuff called the Armory. And this can solubilize other different nutrients and make minerals more available for your plants, plus give your plants better health. There's basically a Bacillus blends, a Bacillus subtilis, and I think that's actually what makes natto. But these are basically beneficial microbes that have been proven to be helpful in gardening. And here's the other thing, right? If you're having a problem in your garden, the time to act is not in the future or be reactive, but it's to be proactive, right? So if you spray this on your garden, on your plants, right, in the beginning, right, of the season and spray on a regular basis, you're gonna basically populate your garden with beneficial microbes that are gonna help create more nitrogen, help defend your plants from different funguses and whatnot. And then here's one, it's called the Megafoss. So guess what that does? This soluble, this basically makes phosphorus a soluble. So now your plants could uptake more phosphorus, right? So you don't have to buy the phosphorus fertilizer, right? Just get this stuff. And then this one, the Tenant WP is even more interesting. What this does is this is against fungal diseases and root rot. If you have like pythium problems and all this kind of stuff, right, get the beneficial microbes that are going to prevent that from happening in the first place. Now, these are super huge sizes. These are like farm sizes. So I hope that, Blacksmith comes out with smaller sizes that are good for like, you know, home gardeners. Actually, that would be like some of these like smaller sizes they got here. Now, of course, the one that I was actually researching when I found Blacksmith way back when was this guy. This is called the no-fly, right? I have some pretty hardcore issues sometimes in my garden with aphids and whiteflies and thrips, right? This no-fly is basically a biologic control for those exact pests that I listed, right? So it's kind of like, you know, like, we'll take a military example. I don't like to use military examples so much, but in the military, right, they have this, like, in they've basically outlawed, like, chemical weapons. Chemical weapons are outlawed, and we all get pissed at Iraq or whoever's over there making chemical weapons and dispersing them because they are so effective, right? You could wipe out a whole bunch of people with chemical weapons. This, to me, is like a chemical weapon, literally. You know, you put it out in the garden, and you get it there first before the pests show up, so they're already there, so if pests do show up, this basically gets into them and basically takes care of the problem before it's an issue. Plus, you know, these, using the biologics, they're selective, so they're not gonna, like, go after other beneficial insects like some other, you know, standard organic sprays might. So you want to learn more about Blacksmith, you could ask for them at Better Nursery Centers. You could also check out their website at blacksmithbio.com. So as you guys know, I'm all about the biologics and using beneficial microbes and all these things in your garden. But one of the things you guys might be doing every day that can negatively affect the probiotics or the beneficial microbes in your garden is watering, right? If you're on city water, the city water, they're adding things like chlorine and, you know, most dastardly chloramine, fluoride, which may not negatively affect things, but they're definitely not good for us, in my opinion. So you wanna filter your water. This is super important. As you guys know, I do recommend water filters, and I'm glad to say that I've probably found the best screw-in water filter that I've ever seen. That's, like, super easy. Anybody can install it. You don't have to install these things on the side of your house. It just screws into a hose, right? Pretty much like this. You just put it on the end of your hose. You could put it on, you know, as it comes out of your spigot. And the one I like the most that I've ever seen, and this is not even on the market yet, so ask for it at your local, Better Garden Centers. They should be able to order it for you guys. It's actually this guy right here. This is called the HydroLife XL. This is a screw-in style, and I like this because it's super large. So, I mean, this thing, I think, filters like 40,000 gallons. That's definitely gonna take a long time to go through. And in addition, I like it not only because it's large, has a lot of filter media, you're gonna get a lot more filter media contact, which means you're gonna get a lot better filtration. The other thing I'm gonna tell you is a secret, right? If you want even better filtration, right, don't crank up your hose bib all the way and run the water fast as possible through there, right? You wanna just turn it up just enough to run the water slowly through there. The slower the water goes through the filter, the more effective the filter will be. In addition, the other reason why I like this so much is because they have a unique formulation that I haven't seen anywhere else, right? And when I saw this filter, I'm like, oh man, these guys know what the heck they're doing, right? Because on here it says C85, KDF85 / catalytic carbon. And because I'm really into my water filtration at my house, not only for my plants, but for my drinking too, right? I know that catalytic carbon is one of the only carbons out there that actually can effectively filter chloramine. So I'm like, wow, they're using a good quality carbon, and they got the KDF85, which is a better KDF, for gardening purposes, than the KDF55. So this basically filter has it all, super easy to install, gonna be available near you at a Better Garden Center. Now, that's gonna be out pretty soon, but they also have, you know, their smaller, you know, standard, this is the livestock version, but they got the standard one for the home, which is a lot smaller. I would encourage you guys actually to get their large version, the HydroLife XL. It's gonna do the most filtration, and it's gonna be the most cost beneficial over the period of time, because it's only about twice as much as their smaller version, but has a filtration capacity of 4 times as much. Plus, it's gonna get your water cleaner so that you're not gonna hurt the beneficials in your garden. All right, now I wanna share another cool booth with you guys today. It's actually called Green As It Gets. And this is pretty amazing, right? They have a product actually that can help revitalize your potting soil or like raised beds after each season. So let me show you guys how that works actually. So here's basically 2 zucchini plants. Do your zucchinis look like this? I know a lot of your guys' zucchinis might even look like this. I mean, they kind of look like they're growing. They don't look super healthy. I mean, they're just kind of happening, and that's because this is in basically Kellogg's potting soil. Kellogg's potting soil is maybe not the super highest quality potting soil out there. You'll learn about my favorite potting soil in just a little bit in this episode. But you know, it'll grow some stuff. And this is what happens when you grow with their potting soil, right? And then by just simply adding this product right here about 2 weeks ago, it's called the Pot and Raised Bed Remix. This is basically pre-plant soil boost. You could also use this, you know, at the end of the season or beginning or before the next season starts. That's what they did here. Same exact mix, treated with this. And look at this zucchini plant. This looks like a nice zucchini plant. So I'm taking them at their word that that's actually what this situation is. I want to get some of this stuff and actually try it myself because this is totally amazing. But you know, once I look at the label, I understand why this product is working, right? This product is driven from a lot of different basically nutrients. So it has this is a guaranteed analysis on here with some nutrients. Kelp meal, earthworm castings, bac guano, biochars in there, sulfur, different kinds of minerals, crab meal, shrimp meal. I mean, this is a really comprehensive, good quality mixture. But then aside from just having the nutrition in there, it also has tons of the microbes that I'm really into. It has a beneficial bacteria and beneficial fungi, the mycorrhizae. And so that's why this product works, because it has the nutrients for the microbes as well as the microbes, and it just puts them actually in a potting mix that wasn't there, and you could see the results. So yeah, if your guys' stuff looks not so healthy, you guys definitely need to recharge it with this product, which is an all-in-one, super easy to use, or you know, source other products to build the quality of your soil. Get the nutrients that are in the soil that are locked up, get them broken down with the biologic microbial action. So you want to ask for the Green As It Gets pot and raised bed remix at your local garden center. So the next booth I want to share with you guys today is actually Terraganics, and what they do is they provide the EM1 product, the product you guys saw a little bit earlier in this episode. They come in all different sizes. This is Dr. Higa's from Japan. He basically researched different kinds of microbes, and he found like the best different 30 kinds of bacteria and yeasts, and basically put that into one product. He found the best ones. So these are like the effective microorganisms, because they're super effective and they work, right? And these can be used in gardening, and you can get some amazing results because you're adding the probiotic, the life back in the soil. And here's one of the results, right? Here's sweet potatoes grown with EM1. So these are like without the EM1 over here. They don't look so vibrant, so full of life, kind of just like the plant you guys just saw using microbes, right? We need to use the power of microbes. And then with the EM1, you guys could see the sweet potatoes, you know, a lot larger, a lot nicer, and more root development. So you're gonna get more root development. The effective microbes, when you spray them foil or feed on your plants, in your soil, drench them in your soil, put them everywhere, right? I mean, some people even take this stuff internally, not that I necessarily recommend that, but this would be a food product, you know, for some people, depending on how it's packaged and all this kind of stuff. So it's completely safe and non-toxic for us as well as the environment. And the thing that people don't realize is that, you know, this is a concentrate, right? You just dilute small amounts of this into like, the water, and you can make a formula and just spray that out. So this will last you a long time, even though, you know, it's a little bit spendy per bottle. And that's the cool thing. So, you know, I think optimally you might want to use this and apply it. Like, I'd apply at least like once a week to your garden, foil or feed on in the root zone, drench it everywhere you can for the best results. And the other thing is, you know, the EM1, aside from just using it in your garden, it was actually developed in part to like help reduce smells at garbage facilities and help encourage those items to break down. So you surely want to add some of this to your compost so that the smell goes down. Also, it's gonna break down faster because literally the microbes, they digest things. So if you want to get some EM1, go to your local garden center and request it there if they're not already carrying it, right? Super important. You can also order this stuff online. So next booth I want to share with you guys today is actually Dr. Earth's products here. And it was cool, I got to meet Milo, the owner and the formulator at Dr. Earth's, and I want to share with you guys some of the products and some of the new developments they have that's completely amazing at Dr. Earth's. So the first thing I want to talk to you guys about is actually a bag soil product. So while I encourage you guys actually to try to source, soil in bulk near you, right? It can be hard to find good soil, especially if you're in a big city. You don't have places that make compost and all this stuff. Everybody always asks me, John, what's the best bag soil you found? So, I mean, I've been testing a lot of different ones, and a lot of them, literally what bag soil products are in most cases, they're basically waste products of one industry that now the gardening industry gets their hands on. They maybe compost it a little bit, mix it with some things, and then basically put it in a bag and then resell to you. So the chances are if you're buying bag soil for like a couple dollars, you know, a bag, it's really a poor quality product. I'm glad to say that I've filled two of my raised beds with the Dr. Earth's potting soil here, and they're the most productive beds that I actually have in my garden. And there's a reason for that, because they make a proper bag of soil, including the microbes inside. So they have basically micro-apply in here. They have a beneficial micro package, including the mycorrhizae and some of the beneficial bacteria in there, along with their whole nutrient package. And this is the results you get here when you get a Dr. Earth soil product. Look at this stuff. It's like nice, rich, deep, and black, fully composted materials. You're not getting big chunks of wood. You're not paying for wood. That being said, Dr. Earth, they make a premium product, so it definitely has a price to go along with that. Now, for this year, they're coming out with a few new products here. They got their Life all-purpose potting soil. This is more of a higher-end product, a little more concentrated, but actually I prefer this one over the pot of gold, the orange bag that you guys saw. And then for those of you guys that lead a plant-based lifestyle and don't want to use any kind of manures or plant part or animal parts in your soils, they actually now are coming out with this. This is the Dr. Earth Free soil product, which is a free and clear of no GMOs, no animal byproducts, no chicken manure, and no chemicals. That being said, all of Dr. Earth's bag products here have no manures. You know, manure, in my opinion, is a cheap filler, cheap byproduct, because basically it's from the factory farming industry that companies source really cheap, and then they add pretty good portions to it. It'll make the compost stink and also may have, you know, contamination issues as well. The other thing I want to mention, you guys, that actually is a industry first for the whole gardening industry is, I know a lot of you guys, I know I am, concerned about GMOs or genetically modified organisms. And when you go to the supermarket, right, you could see that some products have a GMO verified symbol, meaning there's no GMO derived ingredients in there. Dr. Earth is the first company in this whole industry to now have the basically GMO, non-GMO project verified, which means they literally had to send off this product to a lab to basically check on a microscopic level or DNA level that there's no, you know, GMOs in here, you know, because they are not using, you know, chicken manure, and the chickens have been fed, you know, GMO remnants, because they're not using things like cottonseed or soybean meal. Their product has no GMOs in it. Now, just because it's organic or OMRI doesn't mean that it doesn't contain GMOs. It still may contain GMOs, even if it is OMRI listed or OMRI certified, because that's only listed as an ingredient, and OMRI does not really care if it comes from necessarily GMO or not. So yeah, I really like that about Dr. Earth. I think the other thing I really want to show you guys actually is their liquid fertilizer line that's totally amazing. So my favorite fertilizer that Dr. Earth makes is actually this liquid stuff here. They're putting it in a pump format, so it's easy to apply for house plants, but it's probably more expensive buying it like this than it is getting it in the the standard container like this. You could also have it in a hose end sprayer format. But basically, what this liquid in here, this liquid is amazing. This liquid is basically from the supermarket. You're like, how, John, how is this stuff actually from the supermarket? So basically, when the supermarkets or like Whole Foods, for example, goes through and they cull produce or meat that's expired, right? They now send it to the company that basically takes it and ferments it, digests it down into its basically prime components or nutrients, and then they basically put in a bottle. So now you could feed your plants in your garden basically food grade human food that has been basically composted down. So that's definitely really cool. It's basically kind of, it goes under a fermentation process, and it actually smells like soy sauce. So this is probably one of the most sustainable fertilizers out there because it's from other foods and it probably has the exact nutrients your garden needs. So they're taking basically a waste product and now producing a fertilizer instead of taking a raw ingredient out of nature, for example, you know, to turn in to a fertilizer. So yeah, check that out. Oh, and if you want to get the cheapest price, Costco actually this year, this garden season in the springtime, they had this product, which is the Pure Gold. And I think next year, 2019, they'll also be selling it if you want to get it for the lowest price. Make sure you click that subscribe button right down below for the next episode, because actually I'm going to make an interview with Milo, the formulator and the creator of the Dr. Earth, and actually he's known as Dr. Earth. So yeah, check, subscribe below, click the bell so you're notified of that episode. That's gonna be coming out next in probably 3 to 4 days. And if you're watching this after this video originally aired, it's already up. So check the link down below in the description for a video with the interview with Milo. All right, so this next booth doesn't have to do with necessarily with biologic gardening, but it has a handy item you will need if you're growing tomatoes and you're growing biologically, because your tomatoes are gonna get super tall, super huge. This is actually a Midwest Wire Works. And what they have is they have this cool tomato cage, right? This is the kind of tomato cage you'll need. I mean, not those little small, like these small cheap ones. Oh, these guys. These guys are like a waste of money. Like if you're growing, you know, biologic, right? These are too small. Your tomatoes totally outgrow this. This for me is like a good for a pepper cage, right? But if you guys are growing tomatoes using good soil practices, you guys are gonna get maybe 10-foot tall tomatoes over a season. And so they have this guy. This is the Corral, and this is a round collapsible tomato cage. So I like this a lot, because literally at the end of the season, you could just basically fold this guy up just like this and then store it, hang it in your garage. Super simple, super easy, just totally folds down. Now you're thinking, John, wait a second, man. I know like 9 years ago or 8 years ago now, you made a video with the Texas tomato cage, and this to me looks like a knockoff. So I don't know if I'd say knockoff. I would say that this one is similar in the sense that it's nice and large, nice and tall. You could get extenders to make it even taller. What I will say is that this is actually a lot lower price. The Texas tomato cage, hey, they're great cages, but you know, they're kind of expensive, right? And you got to mail order them and all this kind of stuff. The Corral, ask for it at your local garden retailer. Better garden centers will be able to bring this in for you guys, so you guys could have proper sized tomato cages. And the amazing thing is, this guy's a 60 inch tall version, and then you could extend it even taller. I'd probably put another one of these guys up, make it super tall. This retails for about $29, right? Super tall, solid tomato cage you could use year after year, and grow your tomatoes and have nice harvests and keep them trained properly. All right, so now I want to show you guys the next booth, actually, and I have them on episodes before. I saw them actually at the National Hardware Show. Check the link down below to that video, because I showed a lot of other cool vendors there. But Plant Success Organics, you know, Plant Success has been a long time established player in the hydroponics industry, but now they're making their move into the gardening industry and providing gardeners some of the good, same, excellent quality products, and more importantly, tailored to gardeners. So Plant Success is all about the mycorrhizae, and that's where they basically got their company started. I think one of the owners of the Plant Success basically discovered the mycorrhizae. And you know, in my opinion, they have probably the best mycorrhizae formulation, because they have a broad spectrum of different kinds of mycorrhizae. Now they have like a soluble version that you can basically put into water and then water in. Actually, I personally like their granular product, because before I plant any little transplant, I sprinkle it on the root zone. And the one I use is actually this one right here. This is their mycorrhizae. Now, it not only has the mycorrhizae, the endo and the ecto varieties that are good for trees and vegetables, although, you know, they're not necessarily good. They don't colonize things like brassica family of plants. But in addition to the mycorrhizae, it also has a beneficial microbes, which is totally amazing. And in addition, this has a mild food formula, so it's perfect for your transplants as they go in. So it's gonna feed them and also provide all the different microbes in the root zone right where they need to be. And I've noticed definitely higher plant growth because of using this product. So aside from having a granular, they also have a liquid drench, or the soluble version, which is like this product right here, which basically goes a lot further than the granular, because literally you just dilute a little bit of this into water and then water in. So if you want like the 1-2 punch, right, not only should you put these microbes like right in the root zone and water them in, if you want to take it to the next level, you guys want to foiler these guys in with this food product. So this is the mycorrhizae, the bacteria, and then of course they like to live, and then you're going to take this product with their product over here, which is the mycochum. So the mycochum, no microbes in this one, but this is totally the optimal food for the microbes. So now you're going to combine both these guys and then drench that on your plants, and I do that at least once a week, right? These guys will go crazy. Oh, you're going to want to soil drench that too. These guys are going to go crazy. So this one has in it, basically, it's just a molasses, humic acid, also the kelp and fish in there. And you're also going to spray this on too, because if you spray it on, right, the microbes in here will basically displace and not provide a surface for and actually eat things that may be affecting negatively in your garden, like powdery mildew, for example, right? You spray this on every week or every you know, 2 times a week, you're probably not going to have any powdery mildew problems, because the microbes here are now going to eat the fungus before they get to be a problem. So ask for these guys at your local garden center. Plant Success, they're my favorite brand of the mycorrhizae for sure. All right, so the show's packing up. Everybody's almost always left, so I'm glad I'm still, this booth's still here to show you guys, because I've saved the best for last. And what that is, that's actually called IV Organic. And when I first got this product, actually, the owner of the company actually watches my internet YouTube channel, my Growing Your Greens channel, and he sent me some of this stuff, and I looked at it, and I'm like, all right, protects against sunburn, insects, and rodents. I'm like, that's nice. And then actually, honestly, it went on the shelf with all the other stuff that people send me shelf, then unless I'm having an active issue, it's probably just gonna sit there forever. But I got to meet them, and now I better understand the product so I can explain it to you guys, and actually I'll probably start using it now. So the main product is not actually this RTU or ready to use product, the spray, but it's like this stuff right here. It's like a paint can, right? And for those of you guys that have trees or grow fruit trees, this is specifically for you guys, right? You guys know that you'll whitewash trees, right? Why do you whitewash trees? Well, you whitewash trees, basically you put a shirt on your trees. It's like us, right? Would you go out in the street naked? I mean, maybe some of you guys would if you're a naturalist, but I would. I mean, I like to be kind of protected, right? Protection from the sun, protected from other people seeing you, protection from bugs, whatever the protection from the UV, whatever that protection is, right? And when you basically have your tree naked, you don't whitewash it, right? Especially when they're younger, it could be damaged by the sun. In addition, rodents and insects, they like to chew on bark. They like to eat the tree because the tree's food for the insects and the rodents, right? So that's a big problem. You could lose your investment of buying a brand new tree that you bring home because you didn't whitewash it, right? And so the thing is, most people whitewash, just go down and buy any old cheap, and I'll underscore the cheap paint, you know, at the store. Maybe it's even on clearance because they're clearancing out some kind of weird color that didn't work for somebody. Yeah, that's all right, because your tree doesn't care. It just needs some kind of coating. So people use like regular paint on trees to coat it, and then yes, that absolutely works. It prevents some of the sun damage. But the problem is with the tree, unlike when you're painting a house, right? You paint the house, it doesn't move. It's an inanimate object, right? It can't get up, grow legs. It's not still growing. Your house is gonna be there. The paint's probably not gonna flake off unless it's a cheap paint, which is gonna end up in the ground. So if you whitewash a tree with standard conventional chemical paint, right? The tree's growing. About every 1 to 3 years, it's shedding its bark. It's getting bigger. It's growing fatter in girth, right? I wish I grew fatter in girth. And then other things are happening, right? And the tree's always growing. And then basically the paint is gonna basically, it's gonna like, if you have a shirt that's too small, you bust out of the shirt like the Incredible Hulk. If you used to watch that in the 70s, right? He would bust out of his shirt, right? Well, the paint's gonna end up flaking off into the ground, and some organic growers would find that their certification may be at risk because now these chemicals that they whitewash their trees with is now flaking in the ground and is changing the soil, adding things in the soil that shouldn't be there, right? And so that's where this product was born, the IV Organic 3-in-1 Plant Guard. This is basically an all organic and armory approved for organic agriculture protection so that you can protect your trees. And the most important time to protect your trees is when they're babies, when you just get them right off the nursery. So IV organic protector should be available at most. Every nursery should sell this. It sells trees so that they could recommend this to people buying trees to buy this stuff and put it on from the get-go so they could have higher level of success and more protection. So there's three ways which this works, right? Let me go ahead and show you guys how this works. So in this little package here, right, although it looks like a paint can, there's not any paint in here. It's actually empty. Well, that's because they took the contents out and the contents are sitting right here. You basically get two things. You can basically mix these two together in the paint can with water, and then you could have basically a full strength brush on whitewash for your trees that's 100% organic, non-toxic. And what it is, it's a special basically, I don't know, milk-based paint, right? It's basically like a milk paint, so it's all natural organic. You'll paint this on, but it's not just this. You gotta add this little vial, right? And what this vial is, if we look on the back, it says it's basically essential oils, castor oil, cinnamon oil, spearmint oil. And so what this does, when this is added into the whitewash, this adds the step two and three protection, the rodent protection and the bug and insect protection, right? Bug and insects, right, most of them, they have sniffers, they have noses, right? They smell things, right? And so in here has a lots of strong essential oils. So when, you know, a chipmunk or a rabbit goes up to the bark of the tree, they sniff and smell. It's like scratch and sniff. Now they're smelling, oh, this smells like garlic. Garlic, it's toxic to me. And then it runs the other way. So it goes to another tree. So now literally you're giving protection from rodents and insects to the tree when you're applying your paint so that the sun doesn't damage your tree. So that's really cool. This could also be diluted down when you're making it to make a lot larger quantity to brush on if you want to brush it on a thinner layer, or you could actually foil or spray this on to protect some of the leaves from massive sunburn, and it's actually an anti-transpirant, which means the plants won't be able to transpire as much, so they're going to hold more water inside themselves instead of releasing it in the atmosphere. This can be especially important when you're doing transplanting to prevent transplant shock. So let me show you guys actually how this works. All right, so how this is gonna work, you're gonna go ahead and mix the ingredients in a paint can, mix it all up, and you're just gonna take a brush, and you're just gonna brush it on. So if you're looking, this is actually an oleander, which I actually had to cut down so I could grow more vegetables and fruits in my place. But if you look closely, and I'll do a close-up on this for you guys so you guys can see it, this is the standard oleander right here. It's basically, it's a younger, so it's a green stem. But if we go down a little bit, you can see it's like brown, and this is actually painted brown. It's not the natural color of the tree, and that's because they have a brown color, so it actually looks like it's actually not whitewashed. So it looks like that. In addition, they have a white one, so if you want the whitewash look, and in desert climates like Phoenix, Las Vegas, I'd probably use the white one because that's gonna actually reflect the light so that your plants will not get sunburned. And then they actually have a nice green version that actually blends in quite nice. It kind of makes it look like the, you know, fake roses green. It's like a really nice deep color green. It could be kind of legit, but it's not exactly the right color, right? So all these, they basically whitewashed or painted these to protect it from the sun. And they specifically cut these oleanders to be nice and tall and grow tall, more like a tree. And here's the thing, right? Think about it. When you guys buy a tree from a nursery, right? The tree that you're buying from the nursery is not just sitting in a 5-gallon pot or 15-gallon pot in the middle of the whole nursery, right? They're stacked one against each other. So basically what the tree sees its whole life is just the sunlight and the sunlight on its canopy. It's not getting really any sun on its stem or its main trunk, right? So when you bring it home and you put it in the middle of a field, right, now that plant that's not used to getting full sun is getting full sun, and it's gonna get sunburned. So that's why the whitewashing or painting it is so important right when you get it home, right? I think a big nursery, Dave Wilson Nursery, they're like tree guys. If you guys know Dave Wilson, you guys know fruit trees, you guys know Dave Wilson, and there's a guy, Dave Wilson, basically will whitewash all the trees at Dave Wilson Nursery because it is so important for their protection. Because here's the thing, right? If you don't whitewash your trees right when you get them, what could happen, right? Well, what happens is the sun hits the tree's going, oh my God, I'm almost gonna get sunburned. I better devote energy to to the production to protect myself, to make a thicker skin so that I don't get sunburn, right? And when it's doing that, guess what it's not doing? It's not sending energy up into the leaf matter. It's not sending energy up into the fruits. If there's fruits developing on the tree, it's just working to protect itself. So literally by whitewashing, you're gonna get much healthier trees to grow. You're gonna protect it. You're gonna protect it from the insects and protect it from the hot extreme weather. But more importantly, just like putting a shirt on, you're gonna have a little bit of protection also in the winter time from the super extremes. That being said, you still won't be able to grow moringa, even if you whitewash it, if it does freeze where you live, because that's just still way too cold. So that's pretty much the power of the 3-in-1 plant guard. Definitely recommend this for all your trees, especially if you're having problems with burning. Now, Ivy Organic makes more than just the tree guard product, which I think is totally amazing, and I think I will be whitewashing all my younger trees from now on. They also just came out with a new fertilizer product. Now, this is an organic fertilizer product that I like. Because it's an all-in-one fertilizer, and it's unlike any other fertilizer I've seen. You know, most organic fertilizers, they'll be like, yeah, we got 3-2-2 or 1-5-8, and those are three numbers, right? What are those three numbers? Those three numbers are NPK, and those are three minerals, right? But in nature, there's up to 90 different minerals that are out there, right? To get a full spectrum of minerals, you need to put like ocean water said to contain more minerals than anything else. Of course, things that I like to apply, like rock dust, has like 70 different minerals in trace amounts, right? But what they've done here, unlike any other organic grower and even conventional fertilizers, kind of hard to find other macro minerals, right, that are important to the plant and have been documented and researched in studies and universities to be super critical to the plant. They may be occurring in other fertilizers, but they're not. The fertilizer doesn't have that as a main requirement of putting it together. But this one actually has the NPK, but it has a total of 6 macros plus. So it has NPK, MG, S, CA. And basically, so they're getting more of the macros in there so that your plant can be more balanced. But in addition, they're adding additional nutrients. So they're adding things like the rock dust that can add up to 70 different minerals in there, plus a lot of other different foods. So that's really cool. So this is quite unique fertilizer. I mean, they got nitrogen, phosphate, soluble potash, magnesium, sulfur. Sulfur is super important. I'm surprised that more fertilizers don't have sulfur, because sulfur is basically like kind of like the transport, right? So it's like the best man at your wedding. It basically it helps other minerals get absorbed, right? Calcium, iron, manganese, zinc, copper, and boron are in here in guaranteed amounts, right? In addition, they have other different nutrients in here, glacial rock dust, cottonseed meal, feather meal, bird guano, rock phosphate, molasses, alfalfa meal, fish bone meal, kelp meal, all the good stuff. So this is an all-in-one. This is their standard macros plus all-purpose. And then if you want to get even better, they got the super blend. So that was a premium blend. This is super blend. Actually, this is the bag that I got. I'm taking home and I'm gonna use, because this basically has all the stuff in the standard blend plus a lot more stuff. Oh my God, this is almost quite, because there's a few things I'd take out, maybe a few things I'd add, but this is like my dream team of different fertilizers or nutrients they could add, including the beneficial microbes that are so important to me, that are gonna help basically make these nutrients in here water soluble. So this is an amazing fertilizer product. This is the first time I've learned about it. I'm so glad they put it out. There's nothing else like this that I've ever seen in my life. I hope it does perform really good when I start trying it. But if you guys wanna learn more about this, hey, go down to your local garden center and request that they get some of this stuff, the Ivy Organic Super Blend, and also definitely every garden center should be carrying the Ivy Organic 3-in-1 Plant Guard to protect the trees. And if you wanna learn more about this stuff in the meanwhile, you can check them out at ivyorganics.com. All right, so that's it for this episode. What did you guys think? Did you guys enjoy this episode? Love it? Hate it? Leave me some questions and comments down below in the question in the comments section. I was really wondering if I should show up, because I came to this event 2 days ago. We're on the last day. They're totally packing up now. I got to get going. But I came back because I'm like, you know, I woke up went to bed last night, before I went to bed, I'm like, you know what, John, you should go to that show and show some of your favorite products, the things that you really like the most, because it can change and impact the world and your guys' lives by showing these products. And if I didn't have this episode, you guys wouldn't have learned about all these products, right? Did you like it? Should I continue to come to shows? If you liked it, hey, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. Also, be sure to leave your questions and comments down below. Let me know, actually, down in the questions and comments down below, leave me a comment. Which of these products that I showed you guys today did you like the most and you think is the coolest, right? Let me know, and if you do, I'll try to maybe get some of those products in my garden, use them myself, and make a specific video on it, showing usage, sharing with you guys more of my opinions, because it's, you know, when I got people here telling me and trying to sell me something, I'm kind of like, all right, but after I use it and know how it works myself, it's a lot different. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below. I come out with videos every 3 to 4 days, and if you click the subscribe button and click the bell, you'll be notified when my new and upcoming videos come out, so you can check them out as soon as they come out. Also, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge. Over 1,400 episodes at this time teach you guys all aspects of gardening. Whether I'm coming to shows, showing you guys new products, whether I'm going to different farms, showing you guys stuff in my backyard, I have more videos than anybody else, covering a wide, diverse range of topics that you're not really gonna hear anywhere else. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and until then, remember, keep on growing.